Hi everyone, I hope you had a good weekend. So today let's carry on our discovery of the Bodleian Library. So we have seen already the Divinity School, Duke Humfrey Library. So now let's explore the new Bodleian Library. So that building is located at the bottom of Broad Street here, and in the corner also with Parks Road. So if you head to this direction, you will discover the Natural History Museum. We will see this in another episode. And also now, this new Bodleian Library was originally built in 1930s by Giles Gilbert Scott. He also designed other buildings in Oxford, but this is one of them. And for example, what happened as well is that in 1946, when this building was refurbished, it was officially opened by the King George VI at that time. And when they came to open, like when the person in charge of opening the door was here with the key, ceremonial key, let's open the door, a problem happened. Yes, the key broke in the lock. Ooh. So the king and the queen had to wait much longer to be able to get inside the building and discover what there is. But thank goodness, after that, they were able to visit, ask questions, different things. And later on, in 2012, there were major refurbishment, like more modern this time, to add some floors to the top of the ceiling, because we had to accommodate much more books. Okay, so here we are. So and then we have now this area, so which is also looking much more modern, which is the entrance basically. So that's the big entrance. You come here from Broad Street, and here on the right hand side is where you have the welcome desk. And on the side here, on the right hand side, on the left hand side is where you can see the cafe basically. So there is a coffee shop where you can enjoy a tea, have lunch, and you can have a nice view of the books. But what you can have as well for free is to attend free exhibitions. So one of them is known as the Art of Advertising, okay, which was here before the lockdown, but as unfortunately they had to close the doors, they have decided, and luckily they have put online most of the exhibition, most of the artifacts which were here online. So I'll put the website later on the Facebook page, then you will be able to have a look afterwards, because it's really worth having a look. And yeah, recently in 2012 until 2015, as we said, they did a 3 years major refurbishment, which were this time inaugurated by him, by His Royal Highness the Duke of Cambridge. He came here on the same day, today, on the 11th of May, but 2016. So 4 years ago, this picture was taken by me. Don't you think he's waving at me to say hi, Jessica? No, maybe not. And he was here to officially open. For him, no problem, no issue, no problem of key, everything went all right. And he was able to discover this kind of area, for example, where students are able to study. And you know, we mentioned many, like already three buildings which belong to the Bodleian Libraries, but there are many, many of them. There are about 100 Bodleian Libraries across Oxford, and which are here to accommodate the books, basically. Now, there are digital books, there are maps, there are different things, and basically, Also, why there are so many books? There are many books like these because in 1610 there was an agreement which was signed by Thomas Bodley between Thomas Bodley in Oxford and the Stationers' Company, which is a printing company in London. And this agreement allows, and the Bodleian Library now has to accept one copy of every single book printed in the UK. That's why there are many, many of them. And how many, according to you? There are about 13 million books which belong to the Bodleian Libraries. But not only in here, there will be also the Radcliffe Camera, the beautiful round building we mentioned, all those 100 libraries. Plus also they had to build a library in Swindon, which is near like about 30 miles, I would say, from Oxford. And this is to accommodate more books, basically. So there are about 8 million books in Swindon and the rest is kept in Oxford. And between the two cities, every week there is like a travel journey between with books between the two cities to be able to help the students to read those books, because as we still mentioned, it's a reading library and not a lending library. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this third part and I will see you soon. Take care, bye.